Welcome to this session. Today we will be covering the final part for the class on silogisms. In the previous two classes, we have talked about introduction on how to solve the problems related to silogisms and the cases of unconditional valid forms. Now, today what we would be doing is the conditional valid forms, which is a bit tricky concept. So, let's understand where to apply the conditional valid forms and why do we need to apply those. When we are applying a conditional valid forms, we would be using a term which is known as existential falsity. Now let's do a quick recap of what we have done. So we talked about square of a position, which mentions A, E, I and O, the above two as universal statements and below two as particular statements. So this is all. This is none, this is some, and this is some are not. These two on the right, on the left hand side are affirmative statements and on the right hand side are negative statements. Now, the another important thing that we took into account was there are two premises based on which we have a conclusion. Whenever we are talking about conditionally valid forms, the most and the prior important thing we need to remember is the two premises here would be universal in nature. That means it should be either A or E, and the conclusion should always be particular. That means it would be either I or O. Only in the cases where the premises is A and E and the conclusion is I and O, I can say that I am applying the conditional valid forms or I am talking about existential fallacy. Now let's understand what is this term existential fallacy. I have two statements or two premises here based on which I am trying to draw the conclusion. So let's first understand what are the two premises. The two premises is all and the conclusion is some. That means these two are universal facts and this is a particular fact. So this is A and this is I. So this is an example of conditionally valid form. The first thing and the foremost thing that we can understand here. Now, the first statement says all dragons can throw fire. The next statement says all dragons can fly. So I can say some flying creatures throw fire, and this statement can only and only be true if there is some or at least one dragon that exists. If there is no dragon that exists, I cannot say there are some flying creatures that throw fire. So this is what we understand the term existential fallacy. That means there should be at least one dragon that has to exist in order to make this conclusion true. This conclusion cannot be true if there is not a single dragon that exists. If there is not a single dragon that exists, I cannot say the creatures who fly throw fire. I can say creatures who fly throw fire only if there is at least one dragon, because dragons throw fire, that is correct, and dragons can fly, that is correct. So only if I have one dragon with me, I can say some flying creatures throw fire. Again, an important thing to recall from the previous lectures is this, that whatever premises we are taking, we are assuming those premises to be true in absolute terms. We are not considering then that in reality whether dragon exists, dragon throws fire or not, dragon has wings or not. Whatever is given in the premises or the preposition here, we consider those two prepositions as true, and based on that only we are deriving the conclusion. So this is one classic example of existential fallacy. Now let's try to understand the same concept with another example. So my next example here is, everyone who solves this puzzle is smart. Everyone who solves this puzzle is intelligent. And based on that, I am trying to conclude that some intelligent people are smart. Now, some intelligent people are smart can be concluded only when there is at least one person who is able to solve this puzzle. So now, let me try to draw the same Venn diagram that we have used for the previous lectures. So I have a circle of person who can solve this puzzle. I have another circle of smart. I have another circle of intelligent. Now, everyone who solves this puzzle is smart. So everyone who can solve this puzzle is smart. So it should follow in this region. So I am removing this region. Everyone who solves this puzzle should be intelligent. That means I am removing this region. Now what is left is this. I can say some intelligent people are smart, can be here or here. Now, for some intelligent people to be smart, I should have at least one person who can solve this puzzle. And if I have at least one person who can solve this puzzle, I can say that some intelligent people are smart because this one is lying here. So this is how we understand the concept of existential fallacy, which helps us understand the conditionally valid forms. Now, as I mentioned, there should be universal statements in the premises and particular in the conclusion. So, what are the cases that I can have? I can have AAI, that is all sum. The another case I can have EAO, that is some, all, and some are not. The next case that I can have is AEO, that is all, some, and some are not. So these would be the three cases of conditionally valid forms that we would be trying to study today. Now, we will be talking about the first case of AAI, and this is case 3. We are doing the same things that we have done in the previous two lectures. So this denotes your birds, this denotes your animals, and this denotes your parrots again. Now, I have the two premises and I have a conclusion. Now let me try to understand this. All birds are animals, so all the birds are animals, that means this region is gone. Now I have all birds are parrots, so all the birds are parrots, that means everyone should fall in this region. This region is already gone. So now what will go is this region. Now I am saying some parrots are animals. Now when I am trying to say some parrots are animals, I should have at least one bird here. There should be bird that must exist here, based on which I can say that some parrots are animals would be true. So this question I can solve in two different forms. The first form is, let's assume an imaginary creature which is unicorn. Now if there is an imaginary creature which is unicorn, I am saying all unicorns are animals, all unicorns are parrots. And then I am saying some parrots are animals. But since unicorn is an imaginary creature, I am not sure whether it exists or not. What would happen is, I would remove this unicorn. Since there is no unicorn left, I cannot say there is a relationship between parrots and animals. So parrots and animals are independent here. So that means I cannot draw a conclusion that some parrots are animals. It would be incorrect. So AAI is correct only in cases of conditional forms where something exists. Now let's move on to the same question again. So I am removing that imaginary creature and bringing back the birds here. Now what we would be trying to understand here, is the most generalized form of solving the conditionally valid questions. Now, since you have a conditionally valid forms, you always have to apply a condition. If something exists, then only this statement can be true. So again, I have birds, animals and parrots here. All birds are animals, so I remove this region. Next statement, I say all birds are parrots, so I remove this region. Now, in order for some parrots to be animal, I should have at least one bird here, or there should be at least a bird in this region, based on which I can say some parrots are animals. So what is important here is the existence of bird. And this bird is M. So in case of AAI3, I can say M must exist in order for this conclusion to be valid or this conclusion to be true. Now, let us take another example of AAI and see what is essential there. So, I have another example of AAI and this is case 1. Now, let's see what happens here. I'll start drawing what is given in the question. So, all birds are animals. All birds are animals. So, this region is gone. Now I say all parrots are birds. So all parrots are birds. That means this region is also gone. Now I am saying some parrots are animals. Some parrots can be animals when? Some parrots can be animals only when there is parrot that exists. If there is no existence of the parrot, I cannot say there can be some parrots that are animals. So some parrots are animals. I can say only when there is at least one parrot that exists here. And since that is the case, this is AAI1 case. And for this, parrots must exist. So what is important is S must exist. Now let's do another case. So AAI is the most typical case where you have different conditions where different elements must exist. Now this is an AAI case of 4. Now here I am saying all animals are birds. So all the animals are birds. So I am removing this section of animals. Now I am saying all birds are parrots. So all the birds here are parrots, so which means they should fall in this region. So I am removing the remaining region. Now, can I say some birds are animals? Some birds are animals is only true if there is at least one animal that exists. As long as here there is one animal that exists, I can say some parrots are animals. So there should be at least one animal that exists here in order to say that some parrots are animals. So in case of AAI4, I must say there should be P that should exist. So you have animals that is must here. That must exist. So in this case, you have, there should be at least one animal that must exist in order to make this conclusion valid that some parrots are animals. Now, in AAI, these three were the correct forms. Now let's look out onto an incorrect example of AAI. So now what remains with AAI is the form 2. So if I generate a form 2 here, I say all animals are birds. So all animals are birds. So they must fall into this region. So I am removing the remaining region here. Next statement I say all parrots are birds. So all parrots are birds. That means they should fall here. So I am removing the remaining section here. Now what is the next statement? Some parrots are animals. I am not sure whether some parrots are animals or not, because those parrots can be here. Those parrots can be here. If those parrots are here, I cannot say some parrots are animals because they are lying outside the region. So this conclusion becomes incorrect in absolute form. So you don't have to apply any conditional validity in this case, and AAI 2 comes to be invalid. Now this was the first example that we have talked about, that is AAI. Now let's talk about the next example, that is AEO. Now in case of AEO, the first is all, the second is some, and the third is some are not. Now the first case that I have here is a case of AEO 2. Now in case of AEO 2 and 4, AEO 2 and 4 are the valid forms, or the conditionally valid forms. The rest two are incorrect forms. So let's look at one of the conditionally valid forms and see what is important here to exist. So I have all animals are birds. So this is birds, animals, and parrots again. All animals are birds, that means they should fall in this region. So I am removing this section. Then I say no parrots are birds. So parrots and birds, they don't have any relation. So I am removing this section. Now I say some parrots are not animals. Some parrots are not animals can be true only if you have at least one parrot that is in this region. So what is important here is that parrots must exist, and parrot is S here. So I must say S must exist. So as long as there is one parrot here, I can say some parrots are not animals is a correct statement. So for 2 and 4 both, S must exist is the correct form, and you have parrots that must exist in order for the conclusion to be valid. Now let's move on to a incorrect form of AEO. So the incorrect form of AEO, I am taking the example 3 here. Now let's see what I am drawing here. So I have all birds are animals. So again, this is the section where I am drawing all birds are animals. In the next section, I am saying no birds are parrots. So no birds are parrots. I am removing out this region again. Then I am saying some parrots are not animals. So when I am saying some parrots are not animals, what does that mean? There are some parrots which are not animals. I am not sure. I cannot say whether there is a parrot that exists here or not based on these two statements. Okay, so that is a kind of incorrect explanation for AEO. Now next is EAO. So now another rule that we must recall from the previous classes is you have some, all, and some are not. Whenever there is some that kind, none, all, and some are not. So whenever you are trying to use this case, what you are trying to do is you are trying to understand all the particular or universal cases. So I have no animals are birds. So I have birds, animals, and parrots here. I am saying no animals are birds. That means there is no relationship between birds and animals here. I am saying all parrots are birds. So all the parrots here should fall in the category of birds. So I am removing the remaining region. I have removed this region. Now what is left here is some parrots are not animals. Some parrots are not animals, I can say it is correct only if there is at least one parrot that exists here. So I have at least one parrot that exists here, and if that is the case, I cannot say some parrots are not animals. So some parrots are not animals is correct only when you have parrots that exist here. So what is important here that must exist is parrots, and that is again S must exist. This is a case of EAO 2, and in case of EAO all the forms 1, 2, 3 and 4 are conditionally valid forms. Now we would be doing another example of EAO. Now this is a case of EAO 3 that we would be doing today. So here let's mark out the regions again. No birds are animals, so I have no relationship between birds and animals, so this region is gone. Now in the next statement I say all birds are parrots, so all the birds are parrots, that means this region does not exist. Now if I say some parrots are not animals, that can be true only if there is at least one bird that exists here. I can say there are some parrots which are not animals and which are falling outside the circle of animals. For that, what is important is what must exist here is bird must exist. So what must exist is M must exist. So M is the cancelling term here, that is birds. And here what is important that must exist is the birds. So for this premise, that is EAO3, to be true, it is very important that there should be at least one bird which is lying in this region. And as long as there is one bird is in this region, I can say some parrots are not animals is correct, because there is one bird here and which is outside the circle of animals, and this makes the conclusion true. So with this, what we have covered today is the conditionally valid forms of syllogism problems. So we have covered syllogism in three lectures. The first lecture we talked about the three concepts, the Venn diagram, the four conditions that we have introduced, and the square of opposition. In the next class we have discussed the various examples of unconditionally valid forms, and in today's class we have talked about the conditionally valid forms. They exist only and only when the two premises are universal and the conclusion is particular. So premises should be either A or E, and conclusion should be either I or O, and there should be existential fallacy that applies to these cases. Only then we can understand the cases of conditionally valid forms. In the subsequent lecture, we would be covering various examples.